relationship, it's good to have separate passions, but it's also good to find commonalities that you can share together that will inevitably bring you closer. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you a few images, and I'd like you both to tell me which you prefer. Vanilla or chocolate?
Chocolate.
Vanilla.
Sunny or snowy?
Sunny.
Snowy.
What do you mean snowy?
When it's snowing outside, it gives us a chance to relax.
You are so lazy. Dinner or dessert?
Dessert.
Dinner.
Boring. Friday or Saturday?
Yeah, Saturday.
Friday.
Who likes Friday over Saturday?
I like having the weekend to look forward to.
But you have work on Friday.
Still.
Okay, well, on vacation, do you prefer big cities or beaches?
Big cities.
I like to see all the museums and things.
When is the last time you walked into a museum?
I was in your mother's house 3 weeks ago. You know what? Let's move this along. It's totally fine that you both have separate passions and preferences. I'm sure that keeps it interesting, right? Let's move on to the next evaluation. This is much more important anyway, because it really is going to help define compatibility. Please tell me what you hear when I play this recording.
Laurel. Laurel.
It sounds like some deep voice saying Laurel or something.
And what do you hear?
The recording is clearly saying Yanny. I don't know why y'all are fucking with me.
Interesting.
What do you mean interesting? I can hear it clear as day. It's Yanny.
What if I told you roughly 90 million people chimed in to answer this pressing question, and over half of them were wrong? You, Barbie, are wrong too.
Excuse me?
I think we should probably head out. This has been quite revelatory.
Barbie, you're gonna have to get comfortable with being wrong once in a while. The correct answer is Laurel. That's it. Shop across the hall.
Ooh, where?
3, 2, 1, sleep! Rise and shine. I think it's important to finish our session. We're breaking some new ground here that will ultimately help this relationship flourish in the long haul. I'm gonna have your boyfriend read a few things from these cards, and I want you to repeat back to me exactly what you hear him say.
Babe, I was gonna do the laundry later tonight.
What do you hear?
Babe, there's an 8% chance that I might put some clothes in the washer before you get home from work. You'll probably end up finishing the job, and I probably won't thank you for helping me.
Okay, what about this?
Babe, she's just a friend.
Repeat that back exactly as you heard it.
Babe, I most likely said or messaged something inappropriate to a member of the opposite sex.
Okay, let's continue.
Babe, you're making a big deal out of nothing.
Babe, I'm commenting on your completely rational human reaction in order to pull focus from an asinine pattern of behavior that I've routinely displayed.
Excuse me, are you gonna say anything about how ridiculous and dramatic her interpretations of what I'm reading are?
What are you talking about? She's reciting everything you're saying verbatim. I think we can take those restraints off now.
Wait, what?
Honey, would you like your chainsaw back?
Yes, please. Oh, you like that video, huh? Well, then subscribe. What the f*** are you waiting for? Oh, I'm sorry, you don't like cursing? Well, f*** that. How does a person even make it through life without cursing? You know what? I'm not classy, and I don't pretend to be. Anyway, if you don't subscribe, you're missing out on new videos every Wednesday at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Whatever, it's up to you.